that fucking truck and all that things exactly. You can't, and I can't either anymore. I can't. I'm too fucked. I can't have the time. This is talking about a 6-hour fucking project, pull the whole fire apart and put the valve in. I can't do it now. It's not gonna fucking happen. I don't have two fires. Fucking, it's successful done. You know, all because of you and your fucking editor, Elena.
Hello?
Exactly. You know, I just...
Yeah.
Well,
hello?
Where did you want to go? What did you want? You wanted, you know?
All I want to do is wake up and touch you, have you help me cut my hair and take a shower and go get my hoses for the tank so I can spread. I can't even get the hoses anymore. I can't even spread my tank such a way.
Well, can I grab a shirt in the room?
It doesn't matter anymore. Like I said, I what point's the hose? I don't even know my fireworks. It's all done. It's done, Bobby.
How early can you start working on it? In the morning.
I'm not.
Like, the panic is like...
I can start working on it right fucking now, but I'm not going to.
Job,
so 911, what's your emergency? Hello? Are you okay?
No.
No? Can you tell me where you are?
Automatic voice message system. At the tone, please record your message.
Hi, this is a 911 operator. Your phone call 911. If you have an emergency, call us back. Thank you.
Dispatch.
Hi, this is Astoria Dispatch.
Hi, what's up?
We just got a 911. Well, it was at 1708, but I've been trying to call it back.
Oh.
It's hitting off of the tower in, I guess, your county. It's 1.48 miles north of State Highway 401. That's what it says.
You have reached the Verizon Wireless Subpoena and Court Order Processing Group. If this is a 911 or life-threatening emergency, press 4 now.
Verizon Wireless, Shelly speaking.
Hi, this is the Astoria Police Department in Astoria, Oregon. We have a 911 and we're trying to locate the phone number.
Okay, and your
emergency.
Name?
My name is Summer.
And the mobile number?
It's 503-443-803 from dispatch.
Go ahead.
We've gotten a couple 911s. They were open lines. You can hear a female and a male. We traced the number from the cell. The first 911, there wasn't anything heard except for them arguing. And the second 911 that came in, she whispered that she couldn't talk, but she needed help.
Dispatch trainer, are you able to call the cell phone back to get any updates? If it's not at this place.
We've been trying to call the cell phone back, but they're not answering. When she called, she said help. She needed help.
Her car's not here, but they said she's got a very violent boyfriend that lives somewhere down in Alameda. We're going to see if we can find
him. I copy. Do they know his name?
All they know is his name is Dan Newton. He runs for DUI. by here recently?
Copy.
803, be advised, he is a violent person. We could hear that in the background.
Verizon Wireless, Shirley speaking.
Hi, this is the Astoria Police Department again.
Okay.
Hi, I was wondering if you could get a ping off of the
We don't ping, but if you're looking for a cell tower address, I could provide you with that.
803.
Check in house, please. Dan Kaiser.
Affirmative, it's West Lexington. There's a caution indicator. It says anti-police for Officer Deckers.
Okay. Did you get a hold of the cell phone company? Are they going to tell us about where this was hit possible?
I contacted the cell phone company. That's where we got the address. They can't give pings. They can only give cell tower, and the cell tower is the cell tower across the river.
Why can't they give pings?
That's unknown. They just said that they don't give pings.
Gotcha. Can you call them back again and advise them? Oh, actually, Danny Kaiser just showed up. Where's she at?
I don't know.
Okay, you got blood on you.
I guarantee it's not human blood.
Well, I can test it real quick.
So like I said, I threw this thing on when I left the fish factory.
Mm-hmm. So why don't you take it off? I'll test it for human blood then.
No thanks.
That's what I thought. We're going to get to the bottom of this. You got blood on you. You got a 911 call from her saying she needed help. It sounded very violent in the background.
So, Danny, when's the last time you saw Barbara?
Up at the college.
Today, did she leave with you guys left though?
No.
Okay. Okay, Danny, here's what's going on. We got a call from, we know it's your girlfriend's cell phone. We hear a violent thing in the background. You told me that you left at the college.
I did.
The witness said that you and her left in the truck together.
We did. We drove down. I did the corner. She got out. She went inside the cafeteria and did her class.
Now that's coming from her cell phone. It hit across the river, you're across the river, so what's going on?
She's across the river. Like I said, we had an argument with the college, she went to class, I've been across the river, I came back.
How did you take her across the river today?
No.
Okay, how about coming down to the
polygraph? I'm not taking a polygraph, you couldn't be kidding me. Like I said, the reliability of one of those situations is fucking almost, 50-50 as it is. Like I said, I'm not going to go down there and, submit myself to one of those, no.
And how about giving the shirt that I pressed human blood?
She's not answering her phone.
Maybe she can.
Yeah, no, I guarantee she can. I guarantee it.
How do you know that?
Because I left her at the college. Unless someone fucking offed her up at the fucking college, I guarantee fucking see.
Well, she mentioned Dan.
That's me.
Hello.
Hey, Summer.
What's that?
You remember the call at the college about the couple arguing and they left in a red truck? That would be Danny Kaiser and Barbara.
Okay.
He's here.
Uh-huh.
She's not.
Okay, where is she?
He's saying he doesn't know. He said he just come from across the river. And he's across the river. The cell phone cell hit across the river, and he's got blood on him. We don't know where she's at.
Okay,
call Pacific County and see if they had any reports of disturbances over there. Now let me know.
And he has blood on him?
Yes.
Okay.
And there's a witness there. Can you call her and see if they left together in the truck at that disturbance?
Okay. Bye.
803 dispatch.
Go ahead.
That is affirmed. They left in the truck together. And she knows that the female's name was Barbara because she heard that.
Okay.
Is Barbara home now?
Yeah, I just have to say that she is in really bad shape and she's not admitting to it. This is
okay.
Bad. It's bad.
What did she say happened?
That he tried to kill her.
Barbara!
Hi.
Hi. We got a call earlier of a disturbance at the college. And that was you and Danny. So what happened today? Okay. You seem real reluctant to say anything because you have a fear of him. Is that what's going on? Are you afraid of him?
I love him. I know he's a really good man.
Okay,
he's
does a really good man beat you?
He's not a very good relationship person.
Okay. So what were you doing when he assaulted you? You know, we've got a copy of the tape of your call, and it's fairly obvious that he's assaulting you pretty hard.
Can I hear it?
You need to tell me what's going on. See, the problem is right now you're trying to protect him. You've got blood on your clothes. You got blood on your knee.
He has a bloody shirt.
No, I have his bloody shirt, which is probably going to be your blood. Nobody deserves to get beaten. Nobody deserves to have somebody try to kill them. The girl down that lives below you is really concerned that he tried to kill you. And your neighbors said you had a very violent boyfriend, and that's Danny. And I know that he's had, I don't remember the girl's name, I can find it. She had a restraining order against him because their relationship was violent. Why do you feel sick?
I'm just nauseated.
That's a pretty good lump on the center of your forehead.
You got a pretty nasty injury to the head. And you got an injury to your knee, your hand.
And to your eye.
Yeah.
And it's obvious you're in pain. When you stand up, you groan. You've been holding your stomach.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you right now, we thought that he'd killed you somewhere. Mm-hmm. And we seized his shirt as evidence in case you turned up dead. And she's being real reluctant to give me information.
I know, she is.
What did she tell you happened?
Well, I saw her without her shirt on, so I saw what he had done. She said that he took like a torch to her. She said that he took a hammer to her head. She said I could see her hair was falling out.
You can see it big.
But he dragged her.
Did she say where this happened?
At the fish factory.
At the fish factory across the river?
In Chinook.
Okay.
She wouldn't lie to me, but she would lie to you guys.
Well, she's trying to be real protective of him.
Mm-hmm.
Message sent Wednesday, April 22nd, 2009 at 5:56 p.m.
Greg, Bobby, please call me. I'm sorry. You know, it's just, you know, all I do is love you. I just don't want... please call me, Bobby. Please.
2009 at 8:13 p.m.
Hey, Bobby. Oh, I don't know why things went so bad. I just wish you knew how much I loved you. I just wish you knew that... God. Oh, please talk to me.
Get off the fucking ceiling!
No. Can you see that?